Hey everyone, it's Blockchain Bernie here with my latest episode. Thanks so much for watching. This time we talk about the difference between plain vanilla Solana and Xandeum, which is an extension of Solana. It's kind of a Solana 2.0. And if you like content like this, please give me a thumbs up so that I can produce similar content in the future. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already done so. All right, so what is now the difference between Xandeum? And Xandeum is using the Solana codebase, right? So we're talking about, you know, having forked the Solana repository from GitHub and adding more stuff. And what are we doing? We are adding a second storage layer. And why do we need a second storage layer? To make it scalable, right? And affordable. Because, as you know, as I've already explained in another video, storage on the Solana blockchain or any other smart contract blockchain for that matter is crazy expensive. You can store a few kilobytes on Solana, but as soon as it's like gigabytes or terabytes, you're easy in the hundreds of millions or billions of dollars just to store that much data on the Solana blockchain. So why is it that expensive? So please watch my other video about the storage cost in those blockchains. And it's basically because each and every validator needs to have that data ready in memory, not just on disk. And it needs to have it in RAM. And that makes storage of large amounts of data super, super expensive. So where does Xandeum come into play? We create another level of storage, right? So in Solana, the storage layer is called Solana accounts, right? These Solana accounts live in the validators, in each and every validator. And that's what makes them so expensive. So what we're adding is another storage layer. We call it eggs, and it's a scalable storage layer, right? So eggs stands for external global grouped storage. So what does that mean? It means the storage that's in the second storage layer that we're adding to the Solana blockchain with using Xandeum. That means our storage layer, the scalable storage layer, the data will not be stored in each and every validator, right? It'll be delegated to external nodes, and these external nodes are called storage providers, right? And we are launching these storage providers soon on our DevNet, right? The real validators are already running on our DevNet in a very early version, of course, because we're building out our software as we speak on our DevNet. But we are launching the storage provider nodes really, really soon on our DevNet. And that is the main difference between plain vanilla Solana and Xandeum. Xandeum has that scalable storage layer, and it's missing so badly from Solana. Solana is super scalable on the compute side, right? But it's not so scalable on the storage side. It's just not built to have a scalable storage layer. And we're adding that with Xandeum. I invite you to learn more. Go to xandeum.com, link down in the description. Join our Discord, read our docs, discuss with everyone in our Discord or in the comments right under this video. And it's super, super exciting stuff. And it's kind of, you know, next level thing. It's Solana 2.0++ in a sense, because we're adding the scalable storage layer to it. So if you want to know how that all works, you know, more technical, even deeper dives are going to come. So we show you how it all works together with the Solana program runtime. Solana is working on a program runtime 2.0. which will be very, very great for the Xandeum blockchain. We will be jumping onto the program runtime 2.0 as soon as we can. But we are super excited about the scalable storage layer that we're building. But for now, you know, thanks for watching. Go to xandeum.com. On the top right corner, you see the Discord icon. Join our Discord, discuss everything with our vibrant community that we have out there. For today, though, thanks for watching and catch you guys later. Bye.